ich habe gerade die VR-Experience von Star Wars Battlefront wahrgenommen und ich bin sowas von fertig und stehe jetzt aber hier, ja, ich mache ein Interview tatsächlich mit Peter Lake und zwar von Criterion Games, denn DICE haben zwar Battlefront entwickelt, aber Criterion Games sind für die Virtual Reality verantwortlich. So, hello Pete.
Hey.
Nice to meet you, really.
It's good to meet you too. How did you find the experience?
I can say it was the best VR experience I had and I played Eve Valkyrie, for example.
Okay.
And that was awesome too, but Star Wars Battlefront, you know, I'm a really big Star Wars fan for years.
Yeah, this is good.
The best VR experience I had, really. So, you announced on the Gamescom that the Star Wars Battlefront VR experience will connect it with Rogue One.
Absolutely, yeah. This is the Rogue One X-Wing VR mission. So,
that's amazing.
You know, what you've played today is just a taste of what we're going to be doing in the X-Wing. You know, you get to fly as the Rebel. And
there was no spoiler for
there is Rogue no spoilers here. This is just the fun of flying an X-Wing today and delivering that fantasy. So we're going to wrap the whole thing in Rogue One.
But in what way will it connect it?
Well, I can't tell you all the secrets today. So, but yeah, just imagine the things that you've been seeing, but wrapped in Rogue One. So you'll be on a very important mission for the Rebels that's part of the Rogue One timeline. And we're working really closely with Lucas to make sure that it's exactly the kind of thing that you'll expect to be playing when you see the movie.
Okay, so you're working together with LucasArts and Lucasfilm and Disney?
Absolutely, yes. So we work in very close partnership with them to make sure that everything we deliver is both authentic, but also delivering on those player fantasies that everyone's always had.
Okay, cool. You know, I said I'm a big fan. I loved The Force Awakens, and my favorite part is Empire Strikes Back.
Okay.
But the question is, how much pressure does it put to you?
It's a huge pressure. Like, I'm like you, we've grown up loving Star Wars as a whole studio. You know, we did the speeder bikes in Battlefront. We helped with the speeder bike mission in Battlefront. And that was just a huge thing for our studio. And people got so excited about being able to just help make that experience even better. And there is a weight, there is a pressure, because we know there are fans everywhere in the world.
So much fans.
And we are them as well. So we're really hoping and we really focus on delivering a unique experience for VR.
VR, virtual reality, offers a lot of opportunities. So 2016 is the beginning of virtual reality,
I
think.
It is indeed, yeah.
And, but how difficult is it to develop in VR? Is it difficult part, and how long are you working on virtual reality?
So yeah, it's a whole new set of challenges because it's a new platform for us. And luckily at Criterion, we have this thing we call Off the Grid, which is every 6 weeks we have 2 days where the studio can do whatever they like. So over the last year, we've been using those times to people just experiment in VR and make up little tests and tools. And then we had the opportunity to partner with DICE and work on this experience. So it was a natural fit for us to take all of that learning we've had over this last year and compress it into this new VR experience. So
Okay, so you're working together, or as you said, you work together with Lucasfilm, which is at Disney.
Yep.
Do you have creative freedom, or how much will they give you targets?
Absolutely. Well, Lucasfilm, they own Star Wars. They help us understand what is fictionally right and what, you know, making sure that the things that the fans really look out for are all in there. We are fans and we spot them ourselves. We focus on, we have pure creative freedom over the gameplay and the game design of things, and we're working with them to make sure that it all fits fictionally so it creates the right fantasy. Because if you have just a game, that's amazing, but if you have a game that fits the fantasies that as a fans we expect and want to be part of, and that's the bit that Lucas brings to us.
Okay, but why isn't it a full story? Is it too complex now to create a VR story? Is it too difficult to... I mean, I enjoyed really the experience, but there will be no big story, or?
No, so what we're doing right now is we're really focused on delivering one first mission into Battlefront. So this is an extension that comes to Battlefront for free. Right. It allows us as EA to explore VR and get something out there for PlayStation VR players. This is EA's first VR title, so we want to get out there in the market and see how players react to the experience. It's fantastic us being here at the show, allowing people like yourself and everybody else to play this and just seeing the reaction, because this is what we get in the office, but it's nice to make sure everybody else gets it. So if we get this one out, we're really focused on the Rogue One elements now and just really polishing this up to be the ultimate fantasy X-Wing experience.
And maybe the story will be expanded and maybe sometime we get in VR.
I can't talk about the future because we're really looking at this Rogue One X-Wing VR mission. We all hope so. I think everybody has a Star Wars fantasy they would love to play out in VR.